Okay, in this lecture, I would like to discuss about market equilibrium. So before I would like to talk about market equilibrium, I would like to give a brief introduction about what is market. And then I'll explain about market equilibrium with help of demand supply schedules. Then I will discuss about excess supply and excess demand. So these are the things that I will discuss in today's lecture. Before I would like to discuss about market equilibrium, first we should know what is market. Market, most of the people, if you ask any non-economic student, maybe any general person, they think that market means a place where buyers and sellers exchanging the product. That place is called market. Traditionally, people will speak like that. They will define market like that. Whenever buyers will be there and sellers will be there, so buyers buy the products and sellers sell the product, selling the product is called market. That place is called market. It could be any kind of market, you can say. But in economics, I'm not saying that is wrong answer. That is not 100% correct. Yeah, market means which is not related to a particular place. Most of the people, whenever these people, they're defining the market. Market means a particular place, buyers and sellers exchanging the products for the money. But in economics, that is not, I'm not saying that is wrong. That is not 100% correct. Then what do you mean market? No, market means buying and selling takes place anywhere in the world. It is not related to a particular place. That we have to understand. This can happen because of science and technology. Due to the development of science and technology, yes, market can take place anywhere in the world. Let me give a simple example. I would like to buy a Titan watch. So yes, you people know very well, there are many online platforms are there, Amazon, Flipkart, and many platforms are there. So I just choose, I have decided to buy my product at in Amazon. I have ordered my product and I have paid my amount through internet. Next day, maybe after 2 days, Amazon Amazon Wala, he has delivered the Titan watch at my doorstep. He has delivered the product at my doorstep. Did I go to market here? No, I didn't go to the market here. So, but here you have to understand, market means it is not to a particular place, which can take place anywhere in the world. That Amazon agent, he can deliver the product at my doorstep or at my canteen, university canteen, at maybe outside, wherever I have, whenever we are ordering the product, we have to give some address. So whenever, wherever I want, I can, he can deliver the product. That is market. Market means which is not related to a particular place, which can take place anywhere in the world. That is called market. Okay. After that, actually, why I have discussed the market here? Because market means here I would like to discuss about market equilibrium. Generally, in case of market, there are two variables which are associated with the market. Whenever you look at the term market, yes, there are two people, buyers this side and sellers that side. What buyers do? They demand the product. What sellers do? They supply the product. So the concept of the market, which is associated with demand and supply. So here I would like to with help of the variable called demand and variable called supply. So I would like to discuss about market equilibrium. What do you mean market equilibrium? Market equilibrium means whenever the market demand, market supply, if both are equal to each other, that situation is called market equilibrium. A market will be in equilibrium whenever the demand equal to supply. That situation is called market equilibrium in economics. The same equilibrium thing I would like to explain with help of table. You can observe the table carefully. This table, it gives the information about the price, quantity demand, and quantity supply. You know very well, there is a negative relationship between price and demand. Whenever the price of product is decreasing, you're going to demand more products. So when the price of commodity is decreasing, 5 rupees, 4 rupees, 3 rupees, 2 rupees, 1 rupee, obviously demand will increase. So you can see from the table, 2 commodities, 4, 6, 8, and 10. So there is a negative relationship between price and demand that you people know very well. Maybe another concept, law of supply. There is a positive relationship between price and supply. When price decreasing, your supply also decreases. When price increase, your supply also increases, because each and every supplier, they are profit oriented people. So they're going to supply more products when there is a more price. That you people know very well. You might have studied whenever we are explaining about law of supply. So here the price of the commodity when decreasing, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, obviously your supply will also decreases 10 units, 8 units, 6 units, 4 units and 2 units. So this is called quantity supply. Now, sometimes market will be in surplus, sometimes market will be in shortage. Here I have to explain about what is surplus and what is shortage. We will get surplus when supply is greater than demand. Listen carefully. Whenever supply is greater than demand, that situation is called surplus. Wherever the demand is greater than supply, that situation is called shortage. Okay. Another situation is called equilibrium. Already I have clearly explained that what is equilibrium. Equilibrium means whenever supply to demand, that situation is called equilibrium. Okay. Same thing that we can identify from the table also. Whether you observe or not, at 5 rupees of price, 4 rupees of price, we will be in surplus. Why we will be in the surplus? Because at 5 rupees and 4 rupees, okay, our supply is greater than demand. So that situation is called surplus. When it is 2 rupees and 1 rupee, we will be in shortage. Why we will be in shortage? Because demand is greater than supply. So that situation is called shortage. At 3 rupees, yes, we will be in equilibrium. The same thing you can see from the screen. At 5 and 4, we'll be in surplus. 2 and 1, we'll be in shortage. And at 3 rupees of price, we will be in equilibrium. Why we will be in equilibrium? I have clearly told that whenever demand is equal to supply, that situation is called equilibrium. Now, our point is that what is the level of price? What happened to the price of the commodity during the surplus and during the shortage? That is the point we'd like to discuss here. Whenever there is a surplus, the price of the commodity will decrease. If there is a shortage, the price of the commodity, which will be, increase. I'll explain in a simple way. Let me give one simple example. Let us assume that you can take this online class as an example. Maybe here there are 100 students are there in the class. I am the only one person, maybe a lecturer. So we'll take all students are one side, me is another side. Let us assume that all you people are the suppliers. All you people are the suppliers. Suppliers means all you people are supplying this pen. Okay. I am the person, I am the only one consumer. You have to take this entire classroom as a market. All you people are the suppliers. I am the only one buyer. I'm buying the product. I make only one consumer. Let us assume that in this class, there are 100 people are there. 100 people, all you people are the suppliers. What you people are supplying? You're supplying this pen. But I am the only one person demanding this pen. All you people are supplying this pen, but I am the only one person demanding. I need only one pen, but 100 pens are there in the market. What you people do? There is huge surplus of pen because I am the only one person demanding, but there are 100 pens are there with you people. What you people immediately will do? So in order to overcome that competition, immediately you people reduce the price. So that is the reason whenever there is a surplus, people will reduce the price of the product. Reverse case, shortage. Whenever there is a shortage, people will increase the price. Let me take the same example. Let us assume that all you people are the consumers. Now, reverse side. This entire classroom, online class is an example. All you people are consumers. I am the only one supplier. I'm supplying only one pen. I'm having only one pen. So I'm a supplier. All you people are the consumer. So you are demanding this pen because I am the person, I'm having only one pen. But all you people, 100 people are demanding my pen. So there is a shortage of the pen. Only one pen with me. So as a rational supplier, supplier, what I will do? Immediately, I will increase the price. Why I will increase the price? Because there is a lot of demand in the market. So since there is more demand in the market, less in supply, what I will do? I will increase the price. So that is the reason during the shortage, people will raise the price. Same thing I have explained on the screen. Now, during the surplus, price will reduce. During the shortage, price will increase. So this is the market situation that can happen. So if there is excess supply, price will fall. If there is excess demand, price will rise. So actually, what is the other name for the surplus? Other name for the surplus is called excess supply. What is the other name for the shortage? Other name for the shortage is called excess demand. So during the surplus, price will reduce. During the shortage, price will increase. You know, yeah, this you people know very well. Already have, you know, whenever I started with the first slide, I clearly state that equilibrium means whenever demand equal to supply, that situation is called equilibrium. At 3 rupees price, yes, my demand is 6 units, my supply is also 6 units. So whenever this demand and supply both are equal at 3 rupees price, that situation is called equilibrium situation in the market. Now, same thing, let me show with the picture, I mean, diagram, you can say. No, you know that demand curve is a downward slope curve, that red line is a downward slope curve, and that the black line is an upward slope curve is a supply curve that you people know very well. Here, let me discuss. Yes, the point E is always indicating, let me explain about point E. What do you mean is point E? Guys, no, on y-axis I have taken price, x-axis I have taken quantity, means quantity demand and quantity supply. So the downward slope is a demand curve, upward slope is a supply curve, that you people know very well. You know, whenever the demand curve intersect supply curve, or whenever these two curves are intersecting, cutting each other, that situation is called equilibrium situation. Why you are calling that situation is equilibrium? Because whenever these two curves are intersecting, means both are equal to each other. So at point E, we will be getting equilibrium. Now, you have to understand, there are two concepts which are there here. Whatever the price at equilibrium position, that price is called equilibrium price. That is, you can indicate it with P star. Whatever the quantity at equilibrium position, that is called equilibrium quantity. So at equilibrium price, our price of the how much price we'll get? 3 rupees. So 3 rupees is our equilibrium price. At equilibrium quantity, what is the quantity? 6 units. 6 units is your equilibrium quantity. Then what you can say about area A and area B? You know, area A is indicating area A is indicating surplus. Area B is indicating shortage. Why I'm telling that area A is indicating surplus? Because their supply is greater than demand. But in area B is indicating shortage. Why I'm indicating shortage? Because demand is greater than surplus. You can observe from the picture, as from the diagram. So area A is indicating the surplus. Area B is indicating the shortage. This situation is called market equilibrium. So with help of this diagram, we can express the market equilibrium with help of the diagram also. Same thing, what I have explained there, same thing I can explain here also. At equilibrium point E, you can say market will be in the equilibrium. Now, whatever the area which is above equilibrium point is indicating, you can above equilibrium point entire this point, this area is indicating surplus area. The below equilibrium area is indicating shortage area. So when there is a surplus, the price of the commodity will decrease to equilibrium price. When there is a shortage, the price of the commodity is increasing to equilibrium position. So the same thing you can see, the above portion is surplus because supply is greater than demand, and below portion is shortage. That's what I would like to explain here. So during the surplus, price of the commodity will decrease. During the shortage, the price of the commodity will increase. these are the things I would like to discuss in this lecture. If you want me to sum up what I have discussed, no, in this lecture, I have discussed about what is market equilibrium, and what is excess supply and excess demand, which means that excess supply means what is surplus and what is shortage, and what will happen to the price of the commodity during the surplus and price of the commodity during the shortage. So again, I would like to repeat the same statement is that, you know, market will be in equilibrium whenever demand equal to supply. During the shortage, price will increase. During the surplus, price of the commodity will be decreasing. Okay, these are the things I would like to thank you very much.